Welcome to this My Clark at ctcLink video for faculty and staff who provide students with class permissions. To navigate to the information about class permissions, go to the Clark College website at clark.edu. Under the I Am, click on a faculty staff member. Scroll down the page to ctcLink My Clark transition information. Next, select the faculty link on the right sidebar. You will see a list of handouts available to help faculty and staff with ctcLink. Scroll to the link labeled Provide Permission Numbers for students to enter your class. This will open up a document that provides you with all the information about how to grant a class permission number to students. To navigate to ctcLink PeopleSoft, you can again navigate to the I Am tab and click on Faculty Staff Member and down to the ctcLink login. Enter your ctcLink ID and password and select Sign In. If you're associated with more than one college, choose the Clark College tile. Navigate to the CS pillar by selecting CS in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. Select the nav bar button in the upper right-hand corner. A menu will open. Click on the Navigator icon, then scroll to Records and Enrollment. Select Term Processing, then Class Permissions. Note, Generate Add Permissions is a batch process. This is not the one you need. Select Class Permissions again. You are now at the Class Permissions search page. At this point, it would be a good idea for you to save this as a favorite. Select the three dots in the upper right-hand corner of the page. Click Add to Favorites and provide the name or use the default name of class permissions and click Add. In the future, you can navigate by going to the nav bar, then to the My Favorites star, and you will see a favorite for class permissions. When you're on the class permissions screen, enter the academic institution. Clark College is WA140. Enter the term. Use the looking glass to look up the entire list of terms. The term codes do actually have meaning. Take the calendar year and remove the second character. For 2020, you enter 220. Then you will enter 1 for winter, 3 for spring, 5 for summer, or 7 for fall. In the year 2021, you will begin with 221, then the term. You can always use the looking glass to look up the entire subject area list. If you know the catalog number, course number, you can enter it. You can always use the looking glass to look up the entire subject area, such as English ampersand, and click on Search, and you will see the entire list of courses, and then you can select the course you want. We are going to look at Sociology Ampersand 101. You should be on the Permission to Add tab on the left corner. Note that when you're pulling up class permissions, you're pulling up at the course level. So this example shows all Sociology 101 ampersand classes. On the far right, you'll note that there are 15 different classes scheduled for fall. If you go to the last class, either by clicking through the arrows to advance through the class sections, by clicking on last, you can see that the last section is a canceled section. You are not able to grant permission for classes which are canceled. Please verify that you are on the correct class section class number and instructor before granting permissions. Defaults. You will see a number of options to select when generating the code. Class closed is used when the class is full. If you wish to override that capacity, you can check class closed and provide a student a permission number. Note that this does override anyone on the waitlist. You can also choose requisites not met. That would be when the course has a prerequisite, and as the instructor, you have agreed to allow the student into the course because they've displayed to you that they are prepared for that class and have met the requisites in some way. Many classes at Clark College require the consent of an instructor to enter the class. This is where you will check consent required. The permission time period code is used to allow students to enroll after day two of the term with faculty permission. Career restriction is not used at Clark College. When setting up class permissions for the term, start by using the default section. Enter the expiration date and choose the primary reason that you would use a permission code. If the only reason you would be providing permission is when the class is closed and you may add additional student or two on the first day, then you can click Closed Class. Regardless of the default you set, you can choose a different reason for each individual permission. In the default section, you can also choose to generate multiple permissions. For example, if you have a class of 20 students and everyone is required to get your consent prior to entering, you may want to generate all 20 permissions at one time. You can set all permissions to issued if you are ready to issue all permissions. Click the Generate button to generate class permission numbers. You can generate one permission number at a time as they are requested by students. It is not a problem if you generate more numbers than you have capacity in your class, as long as you do not actually issue numbers to more students than you want enrolled. Note the expiration date that you used in the default. You can change that for each individual permission. When a permission expiration date occurs, the permission number has expired and a student can no longer use it to enter your course. You would need to issue them a new permission number. You will note there is a General Information tab, a Permissions tab, and a Comments tab. If you click on the symbol at the end, it says Show All Columns when you hover over it, you will be able to see all of the information. At the end of this video, I will show you how you can personalize the layout of your class permission data. To assign a permission number to one student, be sure to put the number 1 in and generate a permission number. You'll see a number that is identified. Click the Issued button. You have the default date and the default reason. You can choose to change either of those if necessary. And then in the Comments section, enter the first initial last name of the student, enter the reason why you have granted that permission, and then your first initial last name. Make sure that you click on Save. Now you can provide the permission number to the student, and they can use it to register for the class. This is the permission number. When they actually register for the class, their ID number and name will appear here, and you will have a permission use date. To add additional, you can put another number in. It will generate additional codes. And you can assign those to additional students. Make sure you click on Issued and verify that the date and the reason is accurate. An important note regarding lecture and lab components When there's a course that's lecture and lab, the class permission code for either the lab or the lecture will work for a student to register for both. If there are two labs connected with one lecture course, only the lab codes will allow the student to enroll, not the lecture code. The student will then be automatically registered for the lecture that's attached to the lab. To personalize your class permissions data layout, click on Personalize. You can then reorder the fields. I have chosen to move career restrictions to the end, as that is not used at Clark College. I have reordered the fields in the order that I will use them, and moved those items, such as the ID and name and permission use date, to the end of the row, because I will not see those until a student actually uses the permission number that I have issued. Click OK when you are finished personalizing. When I click on this Show All Columns, you will see that I now have it in an order that allows me to issue, verify a date, verify my reason, enter my comments, and then I have finished what I need to do. Here is an example of what you will see once you have issued and students have started to use their permission numbers. You will see the ID of the student who has used the permission, the status as used, or used but waitlisted, the student's name, and the date that the permission was used. For additional information or assistance, please contact Enrollment Services at enroll@clark.edu.